Boys?
Yeah, Larry, thanks.
Oh, that's all right. Hey, listen, maybe you'd better take another one so the boys can see how I get that leg drive.
No, just give me one of you standing right there.
Oh, all right. Wait a minute. Bob's crouching at the start. No, wait a minute. Yeah, this would be better running. Well, look, how about this? Would this? Yeah, this has got a feel to it. Could I have a statement from you for the morning paper?
Why, yes, you can say that Larry Haynes is...
Very good, buddy. Keep that bar at 12 feet. Watch that arm pull.
Okay, coach. How's it doing, big fella?
How's he doing?
Yeah.
He got 1 hour, 51 feet this afternoon.
Yeah?
How are you getting along, kid?
I do everything the coach tells me, but I can't seem to get any height.
You will. Just run up to that bar and throw your heart over. You know.
Yeah, I get my heart over, but I can't get my feet over.
Come on, get out of the way.
Look, I see the prima donna's having his picture taken again.
I know you fellas all ready?
Okay. Yeah.
Now, don't forget, when I get my foot over, hit it. All right. Here I come.
Come on.
Get it?
Sure did.
Say, maybe we'd better take another one to be sure.
All right.
All right.
All right. He certainly gives out, doesn't he?
Yeah, and the funny part about it, he's just as good as he thinks he is.
Listen, fellas, I've got a great gag. You get down low with your camera, see? And shoot me just as I come over the hurdle, and it looks just like I'm going over the moon.
No. We got all we can use.
Well, I don't like to tell you fellas your business, but it's a great shot.
I'm sure you want Larry to tell you how he set that record last year.
Oh, gee, thanks, Bert. Well, you see, it was the 14th of June. The stadium was filled with people.
Just a minute. We heard all about that last year, but it was in May.
That guy's a shrinking violet,
ain't he?
Ah, a bevy of women.
A veritable covey.
Hello, Gwen.
Hello, Larry.
Hello, Mary.
Hello, Speck.
Hello, Nip. Hello, Tuck.
No, you're wrong. That's Nip and that's Tuck. Isn't that right?
No.
I'm sorry, the whole thing happened.
Hello, Bobby.
Hello, Nip. How are you, hon? Oh, Nip, I'm so sorry.
Let's get out of here. Well, 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 the little lassies just couldn't stay away, eh?
What did I tell you, girls? For your information, we were just passing by.
I know. Now, don't tell me. I get it. You were on your way to market for Mother. Look at your man mountain out there.
Now, let her go. There you are. What did I tell you?
Doesn't that guy ever get tired?
Beck, why did I ever choose one of those strong, silent men?
It's an old tribal custom.
I beg your pardon. But the coach would like to know if the track team can tear itself away from the girls. He'd like to have a few words with them. Will you step over now, or am I too inquisitive?
Well, so long, Gwen. See you later.
Goodbye, Larry.
Yeah, goodbye. So long, girl.
Well, that's enough for a while. Come on.
Gwen, you're absolutely silly about Larry, aren't you?
Maybe I am. But he's so conceited.
Oh, I don't think it's conceit.
Well, whatever it is, he's going to be much nicer cured.
Now, boy, to win the intercollegiate. That's the reason I want every one of you boys to get out and work hard from now on. See if we can't bring that cup back to Raleigh. You get me?
Sure.
Well, I'm running the high and low hurdles, so that'll give us two first.
Do you think you'll be able to do the 100-yard dash in the mile, too?
Well, I don't know about the mile. It's a little long for me.
Oh, yeah. Oh, the mile ought to be a cinch for you.
Yeah?
Yeah, we'll let you chase a cameraman.
He's always clowny.
Yes. All right, you sprinters and herders, Get out and do a fast lap. The rest of you just jog around a couple of times.
Let's go, gang.
Hey, Coach. Why don't you take that swell head down a peg?
Smiley, that's where you're wrong.
Wrong?
Why, yes. His self-assurance is what makes him a great track man. Now, he'll probably go out and win both hurdles at that.
Well, I still think you're wrong.
We'll see.
Get mixed up in this. Hi, boy. I know now, after all, my friend.
Hey, let's call up somebody long distance, huh?
Do you realize that this is a business office?
No. Hey, I just saw kittens outside.
Please, let's skip kittens. Now, what else is on your mind, if anything else could be?
Here's that list of probable winners in the intercollegiates.
Oh, well, how does it look?
Well, with some swell performances and two miracles, we might tie Stanton.
Geez, bad as that, huh?
Well, we can count on a first and the two hurdles.
Has Larry got you doing it, too?
Hey, by the way, how's he making out in the Joe Senior contest?
Oh, nothing to it. He's way out front.
Why shouldn't he be? He's the most popular man in class with the babes.
Yeah, but that doesn't make him any easier to live with. And once he gets to be Joe Senior, ooh.
Hey, I was just thinking. What would happen if he wasn't elected?
That would be just the best break we ever had. Oh, what's the use of thinking of it? Look at all those votes.
Yeah, yeah. Who counts them?
I do.
Yeah.
Are you suggesting that I'd tamper with these votes? That I, the editor of this paper, would do anything crooked in an election?
Well, now, let me show you how I really did this. Well, there's a hurdle here, and a hurdle here. Oh, and you're a hurdle, and you're a hurdle. All right, fellas, now get down like hurdles. No, no, these were low hurdles. Well, there's 100,000 people in the stands. All eyes on little old Larry. I'm crouched at the starting line, coiled like a spring. Suddenly, the gun. I'm off. I'm over the first hurdle, way out in the lead. But I kick the second hurdle, and I lose my stride. I pick it up on the third hurdle, over the fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, in perfect form. Suddenly, a terrific burst of speed, I sprint for the finish line and...
I don't have to tell you boys the finish. You know who won. He'd be all right if we could only cure him of that terrible inferiority complex.
Shots, will
you? Sorry, fella. Just practicing with the old discus.
Well, it's nice to see you crack a book, even if it's only in fun. What's the matter with you? Didn't you get enough of a workout today?
Oh, I'm not getting that last little snap into it.
Well, you better get a snap into it and get some clothes on if we're going over to that theater house.
Oh, what's the matter? I'm not naked.
Do one thing, will you? As a personal favor to me?
Sure, what?
Shave.
Oh, I shaved yesterday.
All right, if you want to leave Mary all cut and bleeding.
Say, I don't go in for that heavy dating. I leave that up to fellas like Larry.
Did you ever figure you might be missing a lot of fun?
I'm satisfied with a nice, quiet, sensible girl like Mary.
Yeah, I know all about those nice, quiet, sensible girls. Just like a lot of firecrackers. Not a sound out of them until they explode.
Nah. Say, I'm not like you, walking up to every girl I meet in the street and kissing her. I'll bet you get a lot of slaps in the face, huh?
Yeah, but I get a lot of kisses, too. Oh, pull a knife for me, huh?
Yeah, pull a knife for you.
Going places, I've hitched my wagon to you.
What does this remind you of, dear?
The night we stole away from the Kai Pai dance.
What are you thinking about, honey?
The night we stole away from the Kai Pai dance.
Oh.
Remember they were playing this the night we stole away from the Kai Pai dance? And we parked on a hill, and there was a golden moon and a velvet sky. Do you remember?
Uh-uh. I do.
Why don't you just go on and play?
Yeah.
Isn't it lovely out here?
Mm-hmm.
What's that?
Oh, just an old hand grip. You know, I gotta keep your forearm and wrist in shape.
Oh, that music. Always reminds me of the night we stole away from the Kai Pai dance. Remember? It was just a year ago tonight.
You know, in 2 weeks the intercollegiates will be here, and I shouldn't be up so late.
Lucky star. We're going places, I've hitched my wagon to you. Lucky star, oh, pick up the traces, we're bound to see the thing through, we're bound to see it through. Keep chiming, here we go with a wagon load of my dreams. I said, oh, you lucky star, oh, let's pull together, we'll make the grandest of teams.
Chime will indicate my entrance. Everybody ready?
Yeah.
Why, Gwen, how can you sit there so calmly when I make an entrance?
Isn't your heart doing nip-ups?
Oh, Spec, save me. Save me from a fate worse than death.
You better lay off of him. He'll have you in tomorrow morning's headlines.
And leave you out for once.
Cute kid. Come on, Val. Don't waste all that good stuff on a college editor. Brown study.
I was just wondering how long a girl can play second fiddle to a 16-pound shot.
I wonder what's the matter with her. That's funny, isn't it?
Oh, yes. It's all just a great, big, wonderful dream.
Let's get out of here before the trouble starts.
Say, fellas,
you mind if I bring the girls in?
Just a minute. You fellas don't have to believe everything we say. But read the label. Don Cooper chosen, Joe Sr.
What?
No.
Let me see it. Can you imagine that?
Gentlemen, are we to allow such a thing to pass unnoticed?
No.
Well, shall we have a look at these here now amazing social graces?
Yes.
Then gird up your loins and follow me.
Hey, what's all the excitement about?
Well, read it for yourself, brother.
Hold, rabble! Your pardon for the scurvy lap, sire.
Say, what's the matter with you fellas?
Know ye not what has befallen? Thou hast been chosen Joseph Senior.
Oh, quit your kidding. I want to go in and get dressed.
His modesty conceals amazing social graces. Grab him.
Hi. Did you hear about the election? Did I hear about the election? Why, you dumb bunny, don't you realize I threw my votes over to him? About that election, Larry. I did everything I could. Thanks, Beck. I'm sure you did. Maybe I can do something for you sometime.
Oh, yeah.
Well, fellas, oh, yeah.
Quiet. Ah,
Let's have a speech from the E.O. letter. Yeah!
Come on, make it good. Ah,
shucks. Well, fellas. Now's the time for me to hit Joe Senior.
Oh, no.
No. I mean on the piano.
Oh, hey,
show you some nice stuff.
Where's this Don Cooper?
Cooper?
Yeah.
Oh, you mean Cooper the shot putter?
Yeah, that's the guy.
Well, he's right over there.
All right, come on, Harry. Come here, Chief, I want to tell you something. There's plenty of time later.
But,
No buts, come on.
Yeah, but I'm Haynes the hurdler.
Are you Joe Senior?
Oh. No, I'm Early with the Raz.
With the what?
Early with the Raz.
Listen, son. I don't want any trouble with you. Where's this Don Cooper?
He's right over here. Come on over and I'll have you meet him.
Early with the Raz.
Don, look, I want you to meet... What is your name?
Skip it, son, skip it. I'm from the Pan American Newsreader Company. I want to get a couple of shots of Joe Senior. Are you Joe?
Well, so they tell me. You know, I'd be glad to help you, but I really don't know what I could do.
You just stand there. Don't do anything.
Chief, can I speak to you a second?
Not now. Get that Kodak set up. Now I want you to say a few words.
Well, what shall I say?
When I photographed a congressman last week, he said prosperity was right around the corner. Maybe that'll do for you to say.
Sure.
Uh-huh. All right, we all ready?
No, Chief.
Wait a minute, not now. Quiet, please. Camera.
Go ahead.
Prosperity is just...
Stop. Now move the camera right up here.
What is this, a practice field or a dancing school?
Now, maybe I can use a few more words from you.
Well, I don't know anything more to say.
Well, neither do I. I'll tell you what you do. Tell them how you became Joe Senior.
All right, yeah.
All right, ready?
No, wait, Chief. I want to tell you this now.
Not now. All right, quiet now. Camera.
Of course, this honor was entirely unexpected.
Hop. I'll move right up here.
That guy's supposed to be a weight man, not a movie hero.
I'd like to get some of this strong arm stuff, you know. Say, would you girls mind helping me out a little bit?
Just a minute.
This is serious. All right, now, I'll tell you what I want to get.
Listen, Chief.
Not now. See, put your arms up here this way. You two girls hang on to them, then kind of look out, up at them like that, see? You think you can do it?
Sure.
All right. Ready?
No, wait a minute, Chief.
Not now. Camera? Come. Thanks, folks, very much. That's all. Thanks, Joe.
You got it.
Why, Don, I never knew you were so strong.
All right, pack him up.
Chief, are you all through now?
Yeah, go ahead. What did you want to tell me?
Well, I just wanted to tell you that I forgot the film for the camera.
What?
Oh, I tried to tell you.
Me.
Come, come, let us improve each shining hour while we're waiting for old Professor E. Flat, who seems to be just a little late.
And may I suggest that during his absence, Professor Early of the Raleigh Rares take his place?
No!
Get out of there.
Larry Haynes?
Yes! Yes!
Larry Haynes.
Fellow students.
Yeah, man.
It seems that Professor E. Flat has probably forgotten this class, and it's been suggested that we have a lecture with a new twist.
What's her name?
Bobby's just a little tired. So, I'll now introduce the subject of my lecture, which will be the influence of the Pilgrim Fathers upon popular music. Now, if two of you will come up here and improvise on the pianos, I shall proceed. Now, when Priscilla gave the works to poor Miles Standish, and Miles was burned like well-done whole wheat toast, his language was, to say the least, outlandish, and echoed round that stern and rock-bound crew, till in a fit of pique he called him that pilgrim sheik John Alden, who grabbed his hat and bloomers from the shelf. And this is how young John spoke for himself. Thou art my baby. Thou hast been knocked down. Thou art a swell dish. Why, locked down with arms akimbo. Thou hast this bimbo out on a limbo. Dost consider that small of what it taketh? Thou hast the load, dear. Why not forsake it? Love of the Lord, dear. Come, let thy hair down. Give in and bear down. Be the irresistible baby doll. Thou art my baby. Thou hast been knocked down.
Thou art a swell dish. Why keep me locked down?
With arms akimbo. Thou hast this bimbo. Wear on a limbo.
Just consider that small.
Of what it taketh, thou hast a love, dear.
Then why not forsake it? Love of a mode, dear.
Come, let thy hair down. Give in and bear down. Be the irresistible baby.
When?
What are you giving me? You haven't fallen for that massive muscle, have you?
Why?
Why? Because you're my girl.
Oh, am I?
Why, certainly.
Well, thanks for telling me.
What do you mean? No girl's going to pass me up for a guy like that.
No?
No.
No girl but me.
My baby,
my sweet baby,
thou hast me knocked out.
What a knockout!
Thou art a swell dish.
How he fell dish.
Why keep me locked out?
Always locked out.
With arms akimbo.
Nip, nip,
thou hast this bimbo.
Nip, nip, nippy.
Out on a limbo. Dost consider that small. Of what it taketh.
Can she take it?
Thou hast a load, dear.
Great big load, dear.
Why not forsake it?
Please forsake it.
Love all the more, dear.
All the more, dear.
Come take thy head down.
Take off my hat.
Get in and bear down.
Don't be high hat. Be
the irresistible baby thou art. Thou art my baby.
And try another one. And put some in it, will you?
Thanks. You wouldn't like me to polish that shot for you, would you?
Oh, no, thanks. This is all right for practice.
Oh, Joe Sr., look out for your arm.
What's the matter with it?
Well, you're liable to break it patting yourself on the back.
Oh. How was that one?
49-1.
Not bad, eh?
No, not bad. Only Cal Yorker Stanton did 52 feet last Saturday.
You know, Don, we're counting on you to win the shot in the discus. The big meet's only 3 days away, and you're way out of form, and it doesn't seem to bother you. Is anything the matter?
No, just that I'm a great competitive athlete, Coach.
I'll tell you what's the matter. In the first place... Now, in the second place...
Say, you'll excuse me, won't you, Coach?
Yeah, and in the third place, he's our great competitive athlete. But he does all his competing in the sorority house.
Maybe he'll snap out of it in time.
Yeah. Maybe it'll snow on Thursday or Saturday. We'll call the meet off on a Tuesday. Oh, what's the use?
Hello, Gwen.
Hello, Don.
I got your note this morning. Say, I'm supposed to be in training, but I guess a couple of dances won't hurt me. I'll go.
What do you think? I think we made a sap out of a darn good weight man. Say, whose idea was this, anyway?
Hey, Don, why don't you come on out here? You know I want to talk to you.
Just a second. I just finished shaving.
What, again?
My dear fellow, you don't seem to understand that to an athlete, appearance is half the battle.
Come on, sit down. I want to talk to you. Hey, what's that stuff?
Oh, lilac. Witch hazel dries up the tissues of the skin.
Well, get her. Hey, I've got something on my mind.
Yeah? What is it?
Oh, Don, you're off on the wrong foot. A couple of weeks ago, you were satisfied with a quiet, nice girl who didn't interfere with your work And now you shave twice a day and use perfume. And what's much more important, you were pathetic with that discus today.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Well, 2 weeks ago, you were telling me that I was missing a lot of fun, when you were right.
Yeah, I know.
And what's more, about that nice girl stuff. Well, Murray's a nice kid, but she's not as smooth as Gwen.
Oh, Don, don't be a chump. Gwen's only making a play for you just to make a goat out of Larry.
Yeah? Maybe that's why she sent me a bid to the Thady Informal, eh? And when a gal invites you to that one, you stay invited.
Hey! There's a sale at the Boston store on men's silk underwear.
You're telling me?
Hi, Mary.
Hello, Bobby. Nipper's inside.
Yeah, I know. You mind if I sit down here for a moment?
Well, come on. What is it? Don't tell me you're just beginning to appreciate my fatal beauty.
Yeah. You know, to tell the truth, I had a great idea a little while ago, but now I'm wondering if it's so hot.
Well, after a start like that, you know you're not going to get away without telling me.
You know, Larry's a pretty swell fella.
And so?
And so, you ought to invite him to the Theta Informal.
Let me get this straight.
All right.
You're Don's roommate.
Right.
Me to invite Larry to the sorority dance?
Right.
You see? Good night, Don. That was a grand picture.
Those must have been great old days. Say, are there any dragons that you want to win?
No. Oh! Don't forget, you accepted my bid to our dance.
That's just one thing that I won't forget. Good night.
Hello, Bobby. Hello, Mary. Hello. Oh, has Mary been around?
Oh, sure. He's been around all evening. I just invited him to the informal. I don't know where he went. He must be around somewhere.
Nice going, Mary.
Good night. Good night, Bobby.
Hey, do you want to dance?
No.
But when?
Put your arm around me.
Mary.
Yes?
Put your head on my shoulder.
But, Larry, we shouldn't do this.
Go ahead. Put your head on my shoulder.
Yes?
Kiss me.
But I don't want to.
Go ahead, kiss me.
Kiss me, Don.
What?
Kiss me.
Huh?
Give you my fraternity pin.
But I don't want it.
When I give it to you, you take it.
Yes, Larry.
Give me your pen.
But I don't want to.
Give me your pen.
For me?
Huh?
Back on my shoulder. Put your head back.
Wait a minute, Aunt. Listen now. Hey, what? My nip when I just touched. Look, wait. Let's round up the track team and get them to bed.
Yeah, will you worry about that? I gotta straighten myself out with Nip. I mean, Cap. Engaged? Yours? My nose for news begins to quiver. Engaged?
Why, yes. Aunt.
Yes, I suppose so.
Why? Scoop!
Pardon me. Ladies and gentlemen, just cool off and calm down, please. Now, while you have been in here frivoling, big things have been going on. And as usual, your little correspondent was first with an eyewitness report. Ladies and gentlemen, there has been a double pin hanging tonight. Quiet, please. Not tonight. No details tonight. I'll give you them all in tomorrow morning's rad. But in the meantime, let's congratulate the happy couples, huh?
Congratulations. Oh, shut up.
Well, I guess I should say something.
I guess you've said enough.
I think engagements are wonderful, don't you?
Oh, I always liked clam chowder.
Have you ever been engaged?
No, but I had the measles once.
We'll be so happy running the newspaper together.
Yes, we're going to be so happy together.
Yes!
And to Mars, our intercollegiates, and our star performance goes haywire. Can you imagine those two fellas getting in a jam like that? It's bad enough being engaged, but when it's the wrong girl.
Wow!
Well, don't you with me? Why don't you speak to me?
Oh.
Oh, I've never been engaged.
Hello, sweetheart.
What's the matter? What is it with you? What? Scratchy? Nervous? What? Engaged? Who? Well, come on, say something.
The condemned ate a hearty breakfast.
Thank you.
scoreboards will show you the point standing of the various teams. That was Bobby Burns of Raleigh.
He cleared the ball in the pole vault. 12 feet. And a boy, Bobby!
And a boy, Bobby! And a boy, Bobby!
Official results of the 2 mile run. First, Black of Stanton. Second, Parson of Raleigh. Third,
Schwartz of Xavier.
Schwartz of Xavier. And fourth, Carl of what? Time, 9 minutes. And 32 seconds. That last foot of York's was good for 52 feet. That's Don Cooper of Raleigh in the shot put ring. This is his last try. York of Stanton. Second, Cooper of Raleigh. Third, Gibson of Mammoth. Fourth, Gilbert of Peck.
We're likely to sneak in for a 30. Well, we could use a couple of points since Don couldn't grab a first in that shot.
Now, don't start worrying. Everything's going to be all wet. Or I mean all right.
Oh.
Oh, yeah, you've got me as worried as you are. Oh.
Stay in there, Bobby. We're going to need every point we can get.
And then some.
Quiet for the low hurdles. Quiet for the low hurdles.
Come to your marks. Get set.
Coach.
Oh, forget it, boy. Nice try.
Sure, kid. You can't win all the time.
Why not?
The bar in the pole vault has just been raised to 13 feet. Bobby Barnes of Raleigh is about to vault.
Hello, Harry.
Hi, Graham.
Do me a favor, will you? Give this to Don Cooper for me.
Sure, I will. Here, Stooge. Oh, I hope. Kind of high, isn't it?
You're telling me?
Would you get this note to him, please?
Sure.
Thank you.
I never see another hurdle.
Oh, stop squawking. It might have been worse.
Yeah? How?
It could have been me.
Oh.
Here's a note from some girl for Larry.
I never want to see another girl.
Who's it from?
I'm sure it was all a mistake.
Entries in the high hurdles report at starting line.
Think you can make it?
Think I can make it? Entries in the discus report to the cage.
Sit down, look.
Hey, what you got,
man? What it takes to break a record.
Okay, let's go.
Follow me.
Come to your marks. Get set.
Thanks.
Well, what's that secret you got to win?
It's a four-letter word beginning with G and ending with N. Oh, and I don't mean vanilla.
Stanton is 29. We're still 3 behind. Butler 17, Mammoth 12. We don't have to figure on those two at all. Got those out.
Official results of the high hurdles. First, Larry Haynes of Raleigh. Second, Walter Butler. Third, Breaker Stanton. Fourth, Alan Mammoth. Time, 14 and...
Hello, sweetheart.
Hello, sweetheart.
That's Cal York of Stanton in the discus ring. This is his last try. Was good for 163 feet. Now Don Cooper in the discus ring. He's got a tough throw to beat.
Come on, Don. Come on, Don.
Now, 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 we're doing all right.
Official results of the discus. First, Don Cooper of Raleigh. Second, Cal of York, third, born of sex.
There goes sweetheart.
Nice going, Don.
Larry. Sit down here and make yourself comfortable, big sissy.
Oh, that was a pretty nice part.
You didn't do so bad, Mug. Blurry, you.
There are two men left in the pole vault, Evans of Stanton and Bobby Barnes of Raleigh. They have both cleared 13 feet 6 inches. The bar is now being raised to 14 feet.
Whoa!
What's the matter? You nervous?
Ooh, me?
And now each man has two more tries. Evans of Stanton is the first vaulter.
I will be by Bobby Barnes of...
Raleigh.
Raleigh.
Anything I can do to help you?
Yeah. Keep quiet.
Get over that bar next time.
Here he comes. I've got an idea. Listen, you get over that bar and we win this meet.
You've got to do it, Bobby.
I got to do it. Look at the expression on that bar. It's like the Empire State Building.
Quiet for the ball. Quiet for the ball.
Here goes Evan.
I can't do it. I'm all in. I got a tie for first place. That's enough.
No, that isn't enough. We'll still be 1 point behind. Now, you've got to win.
Yeah? Why didn't you two guys think of that early this afternoon?
Now, wait a minute. How would you like to know the difference between nip and tuck?
Huh?
You'd like to know, wouldn't you?
Yeah, but what has that got to do with...
You get over that bar and I'll tell you.
Yeah. The entire meet hinges on this next ball. If he makes it, Raleigh wins by 1 point. That is, if he makes it. Quiet. Please. Quiet, please.
On her shoulder.
Which one?
The left one.
No, I mean which girl?
Yours. Hello, champ. How is everything? Good night, all.